Welcome back to Footballology. So I have a draft prospect for you guys. Another running back. I was trying to lean towards the defense. I got some defenders that I'm going to release shortly too. So don't blow me up in the comments. I'm going to get some defenders out there as well. But this guy I really want to put a video out on ASAP. His name is Tre Harbison. He started his career off at Northern Illinois and then transferred it to Charlotte. And I want to say the Charlotte 49ers. I don't know. My college teams are trash. Sorry. But he transferred out. But before he left Northern Illinois, he actually had two back-to-back 1,000-yard seasons. Now, granted, it wasn't like, 1,100 or something like that. It was like 1,030, 1,040, somewhere around there. But he still broke 1,000 yards. Now, the reason why I want to bring him to you guys' attention is I think he's going to be a day two, day three draft pick or maybe an undrafted priority free agent. Either way it goes, I think wherever team he goes to, he's going to have an opportunity to make an instant impact. The one thing that I noticed in all the videos or everything that I watched on him is that he has good first contact balance, and I think that's really good in the NFL. The hole is always not going to be clean. The defenders are always not going to be there. He's a guy that can absorb a hit and keep it pushing. Now, the one thing that I noticed about him that a lot of people I think are going to knock on him is that he doesn't have home running hitting speed. Like, he's not going to get that long 40, 60-yard run. I mean, maybe if the angles are right and the hole is big enough and, the safety takes a bad angle, whatever the case may be. But realistically, he's not just going to blow the doors off of anybody, which I'm completely okay with. I've realized that running backs like that have made a home in the NFL. We've seen Leonard Fournette in the Super Bowl do exactly that. What guys like him now have a role is to keep an offense like the Kansas City Chiefs on the sideline or like the Baltimore Ravens on the sideline. Because what you want to do is you want to keep those offenses on the sideline. Granted, we know that they can put up 30-plus points. But what a guy like Tre Harbison or Leonard Fournette or even like a Chris Carson, Marshawn Lynch, some of these old school or traditional running backs, is that they can keep those offenses on the sideline. They can keep the clock moving and keep the chains moving. They pick up 10 to 15 yards, which keeps the chains moving and then keeps the clock moving. And those are two things you want. Even Gus Edwards in Baltimore has carved out a really nice role for himself. Now, the one thing that I would like to see him do at the next level is maybe catch the ball a little bit more out of the backfield. I think a lot of people are going to knock him on that. But I want him to be a complete or feature back. I think that if he can learn how to do that, the teams will probably take him more serious. But he just wasn't asked to do that in college. Not saying he can't. I've seen in several plays where he did catch the ball out of the backfield, looked pretty decent, catching the ball in open space and doing his thing. Still having that, initial first contact balance, everything like that. And then he also finished the runs really strong too. It's like, I think he can be the complete package. He's one of those guys that, if he takes it serious at the next level and really evolves himself, where we've seen Le'Veon Bell first come into the league and he just wasn't quite Le'Veon Bell just yet, but then he evolved himself and changed his body, really worked hard at his craft and became one of the best or elite running backs in the league. Same thing can be said for Chris Carson. Chris Carson came in and was kind of like, and then next thing you know, he evolved himself to the point where Seattle doesn't even know if they want to get rid of him or keep him. It's crazy. So I think if Tre Harbison actually focused on evolving himself and changing himself and really adapting himself to his role, I think he could be a really dangerous running back, in my personal opinion. So that's why I had to bring him to you guys' attention. Now, there's several schemes or systems that I feel like that he's going to ultimately flourish in because of his run style, that one cut downhill running back. I think I would like to see him in like a Mike Shanahan or Kyle Shanahan, because Mike is not around, but like a Kyle Shanahan or Gary Kubiak, that zone blocking scheme, guys that allows the offensive line to move and create that opening and that hole, allow a guy like him one cut, get down the field. And I think that's where he succeeds and where he's going to have the most success and just explosion-ness coming off that line of scrimmage. I think that's where this guy would just flourish and just go crazy wild. So definitely know what you guys think in the comment section below. I'm gonna put all this video and all the information that I looked at or research, I'm putting in the comments or in the description box below. So definitely go check them out for yourselves and let me know what you think in the comment section below. And if you're not a footballologist yet, definitely subscribe to the YouTube channel so they become a footballologist. And stay safe, football fans.